Now, let's talk about the technical skills that a data engineer should have. I like to divide it up in three main categories. One, a data engineer should have good knowledge of various system design and architecture. Secondly, they should have a knowledge of some programming languages. Thirdly, you should have some knowledge of ETL tools. Let's talk about system design and architecture. As a data engineer, you have to understand how these systems are designed. Is it a relational database system? Is it a distributed system? These specific architectures or design are important for a data engineer to really understand so they can design a very efficient data pipeline that can interact with your source systems and load the data to your destination system. Understanding this system design and architecture will really help you to build an amazing data pipeline that is one, is scalable. It can handle massive amounts of data based on requirement. Two, is robust because now you can also handle various failures points during the pipeline. Thirdly, is highly optimized, which is to me is one of the most important. That you're able to pull data quickly and efficiently. Now, let's talk about some of the various data sources or data source systems I've worked with. One is relational databases. This is quite common. I've seen it in all the projects I've worked with because a lot of the times the transactional data sits in those databases. And some popular databases are Oracle and Microsoft SQL. A good data engineer, you need to have a very good understanding of the relational database architecture. Secondly, another common data source that I see is flat files. Some people call it text files. Most times in the real world, you might have to extract data from a data dump of text files. They could be in Excel format, they could be in CSV format, JSON format, what have you. But is a common way that people share the data from one, business unit or company to another. Thirdly, another popular data source system that data engineers have to work with is streaming sources like Kafka. There is a lot of various streaming data platforms. There's Kafka, there's Event Hubs, Amazon Kinesis. These are designed to perform real-time analytics. So let's say you are working on a project where you have to ingest data from sensors that are placed on a vehicle. So you have to interact with these source systems like Kafka that stream the data, and a good understanding of the basic architecture helps you to design efficient pipeline. Additionally, I've seen projects where they look for someone with a good experience retrieving data from web APIs. So things like Twitter API, Facebook, what have you, Google Maps. A lot of companies share data between themselves via APIs, and if you can have a good understanding of how to retrieve data from that, it will be beneficial as a data engineer to create your pipeline. Now, let's talk about the destination data systems. So, a lot of the popular destination systems are the Hadoop distributed file system, which it has a whole ecosystem. One common one is the Hive, and also the Hadoop data lake, the HDFS data lake. A good data engineer needs to understand the various file formats that is involved in storing the data efficiently. Most companies are using some sort of cloud service provider. So you have the Amazon Web Service, AWS. It has an S3, it's a blob storage. You have the Azure Data Lake storage, which is a Microsoft blob or HDFS storage. And a good data engineer needs to understand how the systems are designed so you can create efficient pipelines. Another quite popular data storage system for your destination is the massive parallel processing engines or MPP databases. These databases, I've seen them on-prem like IBM Netezza, but in cloud, we have the Amazon Redshift, we have the Snowflake, which is quite popular, and you have the Azure Data Warehouse. So these are more data warehousing solutions that is a topic for another day. Thirdly, another common data storage system that I've seen is the relational databases are also used, which I already discussed in the as a source system. Another one is the NoSQL databases. So some NoSQL are like the Cosmos DB, which is part of the Azure Cloud. You have the MongoDB. So understanding the technology will be important for you to design scalable pipelines.